Okay, I have a story for you. Once upon a time, I really loved Betty Boop. And I just wanted to see a brown Betty Boop like myself. And I wanted to see this brown Betty Boop so bad that I held on to the dream that one day there would be a black Betty Boop who looked like me. So I used to draw Betty Boops and color her brown because I loved her character that much. And then when I got old enough, I had a character developed that wasn't actually Black Betty Boop, but it was similar to Betty Boop to represent this vision that I had. And I started sharing it with the world because I knew there were other black women who also had this same vision as well. And then one day I get a letter in the mail from Fleischer Studios where they were saying, hey, we see what you're doing with selling Black Betty Boop. And it was actually called Black Betty Boo at the time. I thought that that meant that I wasn't infringing. Like, I didn't even know I was infringing. And they didn't even say anything about that. They were like, listen, we like what you're doing. We want to speak to you about a partnership. Can we set up a meeting? And I was like, this is it. It's happening. I was so excited. I was so excited. And so over a series of conversation, I met with Fleischer. They said that they wanted to do a partnership. They wanted African American women to feel seen, and they wanted to diversify, and they wanted to just do a Black Betty Boop. It's a long time coming. And they wanted me to head this initiative. And I believed them. Like, we're gonna do a legitimate partnership. And there were multiple things that were conveyed on what the intentions were behind this. It was supposed to be part of a Betty for the People initiative. They were going to launch other races of Betty Boops, kind of along the lines of what I was already doing, because I was selling a Puerto Rican Betty Boop, a Hijab Betty Boop, different skin tones of African American Betty Boops, a West Indian Jamaican Betty Boop. Like, I had different Betty Boops because I wanted women from all over to feel like they were being seen. And so they clearly thought it was a good idea. They launched a Betty Other People, so they said. And then I noticed that there was like one obstacle after another. And I am going to be sharing with you my experience as an African American woman in business, how I was treated, what I witnessed, and what happened with the initiative and why it fell apart. So come with me and tune in next week as I share with you what happened and why I'm no longer going to be working with Fleischer and why I ended up realizing that it wasn't the partnership that was initially presented to me, and how there isn't an effort to make African Americans feel included, and how that no longer worked in alignment with what my goals were. So I'm parting ways, and I will share with you more in other videos. Bye, Diva. Until next time.